the Santa Cruz Valley. Bringing in the company, the founding of the Presidio through the war for Mexican independence, which began in 1810 and finally ended in 1821, is the flag of Spain flew over the Presidio. On Sunday, class, the flag that El Real Presidio, San Ignacio, and Tupac was lowered, symbolizing the same event over 200 years ago, when the Presidio was moved to Tucson. The flag is being brought in and presented by Hector Souza, and six-generation descendant of the Presidio soldiers. He's accompanied by members of the Tucson Presidio Trust, Los Pequeños, and the Catalonia Volunteers. In 1821, the Presidio commander went south to fight for Spain in the revolution. Taking advantage of his absence, the acting commander, Jose Romero, assembled the soldiers and made them swear on their swords their allegiance to the new nation of Mexico, which had declared its independence. The Mexican flag was raised over the Presidio. Today, the Mexican flag is presented by Señor Juan Manuel Calderón Jiménez, Mexican Consul. He is escorted by the staff members of the Mexican Consulate Office. The United States annexed the Republic of Texas in 1875, and the war erupted with Mexico in a boundary dispute. Interested in an American presence on the Pacific coast, the United States Army directed Captain Philip St. George Cook with 397 Mormon men and 5 women to move west from New Mexico to help conquer what is now Southern California. In their way stood the Presidio, with a 153-man Mexican garrison under the command of Presidio Comandante Antonio Comodoron. At the last moment, conflict was averted when Comodoron withdrew to San Javier, allowing the Mormons to enter Tucson unopposed. In the end, the only conflict Cook and his Mormon soldiers participated in was when they valiantly fought and beat off a herd of charging bulls on the San Pedro River, since been known as the Battle of the Bulls. After their entry into Tucson on December 17, 1876, Cook and the Mormon battalion raised the 28-star American flag. The troops stayed only 2 days before they left to southern Arizona. The two very formative days, filled not with the much feared, anticipated conflict, but instead with amicable relations and mutual trade beneficial between the Hispanic citizens and the American troops. Their two-day visit set a tone of relationship that has maintained itself with cooperation between the various cultures. The 28-star flag is presented today by Wayne Goodman and Dwayne Bigham of the Tucson Company of Mormon Battalion. The Gadsden Purchase was ratified in 1854, but little changed for Tucsonans. Mexican troops departed March 10, 1856, but no American troops immediately replaced them. Yet 9 local citizens constructed a flagpole of Ocotillo branches and ran up Old Glory. But the people were isolated. The Gadsden Purchase became part of the territory of New Mexico. Repeatedly, the Arizonans tried to establish a new territory, but to no avail. In 1860, the United States began to break apart, and on August 10, 1861, local officials declared allegiance to the Confederacy and officially established the Confederate Territory of Arizona, which then included southern New Mexico and southern Arizona, including sending a representative to Richmond. The Texas Confederate Captain Sherrod Hunter and 65 volunteers occupied Tucson on February 28, 1861 and raised their flag. April 1862, Hunter's troops had to flee with the advancement of Colonel Carlson's larger California volunteers. The Confederate flag is presented today by Emily Sherkowitz, Arizona Division, John R. Baylor, Chapter of the United Daughters of the Confederacy, escorted by Rich Montgomery, Sons of the Confederate Veterans, and Ella Stone Meir, President of Arizona Division of the Daughters of the Confederacy. Finally, years of concentrated effort to achieve statehood were recognized. Arizona became the 48th state February 14, 1912, and the flag of state of Arizona flew over Tucson. Today, the Arizona flag is presented by Kristen Palmquist, Director of Governor's Southern Arizona Office, escorted by Detective Dave Romero, Department of Public Safety.